Verse 12, the woman says to Elijah, as the Lord your God lives, I don't have but a handful of meal and a little cruse of oil. That really doesn't make sense. I read the Bible and sometimes I'm like, God, that doesn't make sense. Or, you know, things will jump out and I'm like, oh, that's cool. And so those are the things that I really research and I'm fascinated by them. But I said, God, that doesn't make sense for her to, on one hand, admit that the Lord lives and then in the same breath begin to speak of how limited her potential and her resources were. And that told me that when you're dealing with God, it does not matter what you have or what you think you have, because he lives. And the fact that God lives, and yes, indeed, he does indeed live, it means that God is not limited by your limitations. God is not moved by our mountains. What is impossible can shift into the realm of possibility simply because God lives. And so think about it. Have you ever noticed that everyone that the Lord has used in history beside Jesus has had some type of limitation? Sarah was beyond her years. Moses had a speech impediment. Paul, he had that thorn. We're still trying to figure out what Paul's thorn was. But Paul had a thorn in his side. And Jeremiah, he was young. Mary was a virgin. She still had a baby. And David was frisky, and he had a whole lot of other issues too. But everybody that God has used, everyone that God has required more of down through the years and throughout history has had some type of limitation. But that only goes to prove exactly how powerful our God is. You may want to write yourself off. You may want to write your situation off today. You may have come in here today saying, this is this one last try that I'm going to give God. But I want to tell you, not so fast. God wants more. And God has a track record of fulfilling his will and destiny in the lives of people by using limited resources, by taking the impossible to the human eye and doing whatsoever with it that God does will. Our little resources, our little potential, it does not limit God. He can take the little that we have and still accomplish his purpose. But the difference between those of us that God will get more out of and those of us that will tell God no is our ability, is not our ability, but our availability, is our willingness to give God what he asked for. See, I'm reminded of a little boy who only had two fish and five loaves of bread, and there was a crowd of over 5,000, and they needed to be fed. And as long as the fish and as long as the loaves were in the boy's hands, it was too little among too many, and it looked like limitation would win. But not so fast. God wanted a little more time, and when the resources, the limited resources, were transferred into the hands of Jesus, it became more than enough. I guarantee you they were taking home doggy bags. If Mother Lena Faison was here, she would have pulled a little tissue out from her, you know, bosom and made her a plate to go home. God wants more. You may not think that you have much to give or that the little that you have matters at all. You may even wonder why God wants anything from you in the first place, but not so fast. God wants more. You don't know how powerful you are. You don't know how powerful the little you have actually is. Little becomes much when you place it in the master's hands. The widow at Zarephath, she did not have much, but the truth be told, things did not look very good for her. But not so fast, widow. God wants more. She was obedient to God. She gave God what she had. She trusted God enough to sacrifice her comfort, her convenience, and give up control.